As the government pushes for inclusivity through education for all at no cost, there is great improvement in schools where parents are contributing to the operational costs.
We have seen that where most parents contribute for the school, there is great improvement. But with the policy of government saying parents will not contribute, it is affecting the performance of the school. Given that the money sent by the government and comparing the parents' contribution is high to cater for most of the issues. And given that there are many schools in the whole country and the government fund is little.
In his New Year message on 31st of December 2019, the President of the Republic of Uganda, His Excellency Yoweri Kaguta Museveni, say that if schools under the disguise of Parents Teachers Association continue charging extra fees, he would consider abolishing free education. The argument by civil society organizations is that the government cannot pay for some of the requirements needed in the schools.
Government can make infrastructure development, but there are also other requirements, like in terms of teachers. Now the teachers are very few. If government has failed to support their teaching staff across the country, but when parents have contributed, I think it is a good win that the governments would encourage parents to contribute.
Joseph Nyakana is the Kaboyo Secondary School deputy head teacher in Kabarole District. He gives an example of his school where out of the 33 teachers, only 10 are on government payroll and 14 teachers were being paid by parents until the government banned schools from charging extra fees from parents.
That is a very big challenge on the school because the 14 teachers who are paid by the parents will not be able to continue their services to the school because we have no way of paying them.
In August this year, the Kasese Resident District Commissioner, Lieutenant Joe Walusimbi, arrested Selivano Chilibyonza, the head teacher of Railway Primary School, and Remedio Thembo Ikwera, the head teacher of Kasese Primary School, for collecting fees from Universal Primary Education pupils. The appeal is to shift the burden to the government.
Our request is that government should either lift the ban on recruitment so that our existing staff who are not on government payroll can be hired by government, deployed in this school, so that now the burden of payment on the parents can disappear.
Parents need to be encouraged to contribute and be shown the importance of contribution. Otherwise, we know it is a challenge. We are in a hard time when resources are constrained and the parents do not have enough money.
However, Patrick Rakaikara, the former Kabarole District Education Officer, suggests that since most of the schools are owned by churches, the House of Bishops should discuss the issue and take it to the Interreligious Council of Uganda for further scrutiny.
Take it to Interreligious Council of Uganda. This is a body which unites the Catholics, the Anglicans, the Muslims, the Orthodox, and the SDS, and they are the ones who own a majority of schools, by the way. And therefore, if they agreed, they can meet the president and discuss this matter, and we shall have no problem in the future.
Story compiled by John Antosingwire for the news.